double depth putting green instructional video. Let me start by introducing you to the components that you're going to receive in your packaging. Obviously, the first thing you're going to receive is your putting surface. Along with the putting surface, you're going to receive a base that is non-textured. It's going to be shiny on both sides and is slightly thicker and slightly longer. It's about 6 inches longer than the putting surface. You're going to receive a bumper for each end. The bumper is designed to stop the ball and will snap onto the putting surface. You will receive a hole reduction insert, and because it's double depth and thickness, it's actually thicker than the standard hole reduction insert. You'll get an elevated shim. You'll get three cups and three flags. The cups are independent of the flags. The flags are extraction flags that will fit inside these cups. You'll also receive a can of adhesive for each 8 feet of putting green ordered. Today we're going to actually do a 14 footer, so I need 2 cans of the adhesive. In addition, you will receive a hole cutter. This hole cutter is extremely sharp. We'll package it so that you can't cut yourself taking it out of the packaging, but once it's out of the packaging, this is a razor sharp edge, serrated, and trust me, I've cut myself. It's extremely sharp. We will also give you a cutting board so that you don't cut through with your carpeting or your nice hardwood floors or linoleum. So you'll get a cutting board. Make sure you put that underneath the hole cutter as you do your holes. All right? Very simple. The first step is to put your putting green on top of your double depth base. And again, remember that we have made it slightly longer than the putting green. I'm going to pull this in to the center here, and I'm going to line the edge up. Okay, so I just want to have some overlap on this end. You can see I've overlapped that. And again, it's 6 inches, so you know you've got over 3 inches to balance it on each end. I'm going to make sure I've got it on this side square. And I'm going to pull this over just slightly. Okay, so now the putting surface is indeed on top of the base in a straight manner. Okay, so the edges are lined up. And this is where I have some tools that you're not going to have at home. I'm going to go grab a couple of heavy rubber stance mats that we sell. In this instance, you'll want to put books. Something heavy, flat, with a wide weight distribution so that you don't damage your putting green, but you're going to want to put something heavy on this end, because what we're going to do is I'm going to flip the putting green surface over the top of the base so that I can put the adhesive down, and as I set it back down, it will fall back exactly in the same place that I have it lined right now. So we're perfectly square. I'm going to go grab my weight. And again, these are perfect. These each weigh about 20 pounds. And I'm going to put them on top of my putting surface, again, just so that I can keep it perfectly aligned. And so now, and you'll want to put maybe, again, 30 or 40 pounds on this area. And now what I'm going to do is I'm going to pull my putting green back over the top, and we'll start our adhering process. Okay, so I put my weight on this end of the putting green. About 30 or 40 pounds of weight is what we're looking for. Because as I pull the top surface back over the base, I just want it to stay in place. So this is all about just keeping the alignment so that when I do my spraying, I can just put the putting surface back over the top. So again, you're going to get 1 can of adhesive for about every 8 feet. This is 14 feet, and so I can spray very liberally. And you'll want to do that. Don't starve it. Make sure that you put plenty of adhesive down. Now, I don't have to worry about coming super close to the edge. And the reason is that when I'm done, I'm going to have the possibility of putting trim. Okay, and in this video, we're not going to put trim on the side of the putting green. But if we don't glue it all the way to the edge, we will have the opportunity to put trim back on here. Even if you do glue it to the edge, the adhesive is actually a low enough modulus that it will allow you to actually separate it slightly. Okay, so what we meaning I'm going to put a lot of adhesive down. You can see I'm not even really getting it all the way to the edge, but I'm making sure that I have plenty of it here in the middle, okay, where you really want all the adhesion to take place. This is going to be where you're locking and cutting, and this is where you want the flatness to be important. You know, the edge is super important. You're never going to be cutting all the way over this edge. So again, this is all about just making sure that you have a nice, consistent adhesive application.
Your own X-Acto knife, okay?
Okay, so the nice thing is that I have an edge already ready to go. Okay, so as you can see, I've actually glued, I've got some overspray on my sub base, not a problem. I'm going to be able to separate it enough to get my bucket on. So let's just go ahead now and cut my sub base. And again, just follow, this is going to be easy because all you're doing essentially is following your putting green. Okay, so here we are at this end with the bumper. The bumper is really cool. It snaps on. You look for the tooth. There's a little biting tooth here, and that's the part that you're going to actually want to snap on the green. Okay, so again, we did adhesive all the way to the end of this, but I just want to show you that I can separate it, okay? Because like we talked about, it really takes a couple of weeks for it to cure to the point where you can't separate it anymore. Okay, so I'm just going to separate this enough to get my bumper on. Okay, and I'm going to snap this on the edge.
To keep it from poking through, the cup from moving.
Okay? So there's my cup located in my dream, okay, as you can see. And as we described to you, your extraction flag simply goes right into that cup, snaps in. Now, if you want to orient your flag, the cup rotates, okay? So you can actually rotate your cup to orient your logo on the flag. Okay, so that's the flag, cup and flag at this end. And let's go down to the other end, where I've already put the cups, where I want to put my holes, okay? And I'm just going to slide my cutting board here so it's in place. Again, don't move it until you're ready to go, John. Okay, so I'm going to put my hole there. I like it there. Keep your finger out from underneath it. I literally just almost did that. Extremely sharp. I can't emphasize how careful you have to be with this tool. And you can see razor sharp edge for the ball to fall into the cup. And that's the nice thing about this double depth is the ball will not be able to come out of that hole. Okay, so you won't get raw down under your putt. All right, so I'm going to orient that flag in that direction. Take my cup, my cutting board. Excuse me. Okay. Put this underneath. All right, put it where I want to go, right there. Push, twist, pull. Notice it, it's about an eighth of an inch overlap here, which means it's probably an eighth of an inch overlap on the other side. You know, this is a putting green, it's not a precision architectural piece. Okay, so I'm going to keep my putting green in there, my cup, sorry. And let's orient my flag the right way. And I'll orient the flag by rotating the cup. All right, so that's it, you're ready to go, time to putt. And that's a 4x14 installed by you, and you are off and running.